Dropped it back. Here's Kane. Around a check to the middle. He tried to beat another man. Did, but couldn't pull the trigger. Now left it for Letty. His drop pass did not connect. Now a turnover. The race is on. They might have a breakaway chance. Tangrady moving in. Couldn't get rid of a shot. And no penalty. Letty. What a hustle play by Nick Letty. Then he's hit hard by Wheeler. In an awkward spot, he gets back into the play. Knocked away along the boards. Taves, though, couldn't get beyond Bufflin. Here's Ladd, the Jet captain, looking to center. Here's a chance for Little. He shoots, and a save by Crawford. Wasn't sure. Now able to capture.
Shot. Nice pass by Andrew Ladd. Watch that pass. Maybe jumped on Little a little bit. He had to double clutch. And from your Captain Morgan RoboCam, bad the turnover you talked about. Blackhawks jump on it, and unfortunately, John...
They're on a poor run now. Here's a long slap shot. Crawford able to make the save on Buckland's last games. They're one out of the last 37 with the extra man. So this power play has really hurt him. Buckland trying to drive the goal. He stops it, and a save by Crawford, and that's just a power move by the big man. Dustin Bufflin just lowered his shoulder, stuck his left leg out, and got right to the blue paint.
Yeah, and it was on Duncan Keith, too. A guy, a very good defender with speed, but watch the speed of Big Buff. He starts on the left side, cuts back to the right side, and as you mentioned, as soon as he gets a stride, gets that right arm out, protects the puck, and that is a strong move. Good job by Corey Crawford to hold his ground. Boy, that
Kane looking to center, never connecting with Sharp. Again, Kane just missed Roosevelt with a pass attempt. His feet hacked loose in the middle, and Montoya able to cover it up right in the goal crease. Peg, he's played just one game with him. Played Monday in the victory over Detroit. But here's a steal by Hossa for Taves. Back to Hossa, quick shot, and a save by Montoya, who didn't know he had completed the move. And the Hawks start back. Sharp's got it. Now Hossa does. Hossa gets the line. The trailer is Taves. He's got it. Walks in, shooting. Good save, Montoya, with the right side. And now captured by Seabrook. Long feed to Taves. He's got a man with him. Looking back to Kane. He's right in. Good save by Montoya. Now it's taken by Keith. Dropped it into the corner. Sharp center to Taves. A shot. He's gone. Jonathan Taves could have had an assist a moment ago. Now he decides to take it into his own hands. And he gives the Hawks the lead.
Well, that Taves line has had five great chances in this first period. This time, though, it's Patrick Kane instead of Marian Hossa on the wing. And watch the selfless pass here. Taves with a spinorama. Great save by Montoya. And the Blackhawks stay with it. They jump on a loose puck. They get it to the captain and a stuff between the legs of Montoya right on the doorstep. That has got to be the third doorstep chance for Jonathan Taves.
Frolik, rolled to Bogosian, dropped it, Frolik walks in, put it to Scheifele, here's the shot, oh, good block out in front. Nice play by Ben Smith defensively.
As long as you're ahead of that defender when you get to the faceoff dot, they wave it off.
Here's Kane back in, weaving, waiting, shooting, he scores! Patrick Kane, and a good screen out in front provided by Saad, and the Hawks very late double the lead.
Boy, very similar to the goal he scored against the Calgary Flames. And you hit on the key, Pat. He waited. He waited for traffic in front. Watch him, the patience. He could have shot here. He waits that extra second. And that sets up the screen in front. Great release on that snapshot. Montoya didn't see it. Patrick Kane.
Hayes wins a draw. Keith lets it go to save Montoya. Rebound cleared the other way. Keith. Looks to Sharp, a long wrist shot, tip, oh, the redirect just went wide from Shaw.
To Andrew Shaw, look at the flex in the stick from Patrick Sharp in Ultramo, all alone.
Just now here's Jalmerson, in front to Hossa, to the back end, now a stuff attempt downstairs was Montoya. Buffling around for Ladd, he missed it, Roosevelt didn't, across for Letty, here it comes, Montoya saw it all the way. He'll happily take a whistle there from Bolig, looking for Smith. It was at his feet, though. Andrew Ladd ran out of time. Odulia took it away, flipped it forward. Hossa going to get to the goal. He's right in. Hossa, and a save by Montoya. Jokinen the other way. They got a 4-on-3. Here they come. A chance for Tank Grady. Shooting. Good block out in front. It hurts Seabrook. A long shot tip. And a good save by Crawford on a redirect.
A go. Mariposa all alone. Now Montoya just staying with him, showing great patience. Looks like maybe gets away with a little bit of a hook, a slash.
Ladd has time here. They might have a 3-on-2. Oh, what a steal by Keith. That was going to be a 3-on-2 for Winnipeg. And Keith wound up getting a scoring chance out of it. There, Shaw has shot down to a goalpost from Sharp.
He's in his net, 35, almost on the goal line. Starts the challenge. There's that shot off the left post as we look at.
Now Taves from back of the net. Center to Sharp, who's hacked. Now rebound. It hit the goalpost. And then it was kept out of the net by Montoya.
Jonathan Taves line with a couple more great chances. Out to Sharp. He stays with it. His shot gets blocked. Second one off the post. And Al Montoya does a great job sensing where that puck is. I think he feels it off the post, off the back of his leg. And then he's quick to cover with his glove. It's a good thing, too, because Taves right on the doorstep, ready to jam it home.
He put it in, and the Hawks counter with a change. Back to the other end, Halaschuk. That helps. Seifele had a shot. Good save by Crawford. That is a rare second period decent scoring chance for the visitors. They spent very little time down in the zone to our left.
Yeah, the ice is pretty fresh around Corey Crawford. Seifele, you've talked about him, Pat. Had a big game against Detroit where he's the first star, but that's a quick release. I mean, he just holds up and gets that shot off.
Now it's cleared ahead, a breakaway chance. Peary right in, he scores! Brandon Peary got the pass in the blue line, had nobody between him and the net, had time to take a look, pumped it by the glove, 3-0.
Well, a perfect feed to Brandon Peary, who had three glorious scoring chances against Calgary, came up empty. He does it here, a high, hard one, again. Winnipeg turns it over, the quick pass up the middle. Well, that's perfectly placed shot. And Montoya is deep. He goes high glove. It wasn't that deep, maybe top of the blue paint. But he gets sprung by.
Sharp still able to jam up a jet rush attempt. Puck bounce right to Wiener though. Oh, what a save. Crawford's best of the game, it's loose.
Puck gets chopped actually by the captain, Jonathan Taves, right onto the stick of Wheeler, who was literally 10 feet from the net. A quick release, but boy, good adjustment there by Corey Crawford.
Close to getting it back and unable to make a play. And Wheeler lost it to Sharp. The shot, he scores! Patrick Sharp snapped it high to the very top corner of the net. A Winnipeg turnover leads to a Sharp shot, and it's 4-0.
Well, we heard Mike Kitchen, assistant coach for the Blackhawks, talk about the jump that Patrick Sharp has. And boy, watch him jump on this puck and the release. Again, Winnipeg has it. They turn it over. Good job by Duncan Keith. And just like that, it's in the back of the net. Watch number 10 jump and then watch the release. I mean, that's just a laser over the shoulder of Montoya.
I don't know what game, so they're letting him play on the back end tonight where he's most comfortable. And Brookbank's been able to get a couple of chips up front. A long shot, Buffalo rebound, they score! Corey Crawford made the initial save on Bufflin. Setoguchi found the rebound, it's 4-1.
Yeah, the original shot by Bufflin gets redirected, and that's why it was tough for Corey Crawford to handle it. He was just trying to get his body in front of it, he does. The tip in front goes right to Setoguchi.
Hardy. Oh, look out, geez. The glass came out. A big hit from Bolig, and the glass just came free right into the crowd. Hopefully the fans down there are okay. The Jets unhappy with the hit, but I don't think there's anything wrong with the hit. He just wrong place, wrong time with the glass coming loose.
Yeah, it was preceded by a couple of big hits by Winnipeg, and that's just a little bit of payback by Brandon Bolig. Nothing wrong with it. He just put a little extra oomph into it, and that knocked the glass out of his stanchions. And I think the fans in that front row were quick to get their hands up, and that prevented really any damage from the glass kind of springing into the stands.
And Adam Hardy just got his helmet back. We get the word that for a moment somebody thought they had a souvenir.
Well, there's the big hit. And there's the oomph. Yeah, that's a great check. And there it is. They're holding it up. Wow, that's violent, but that's what the game's about. And there you see the helmet of Party. Oh gosh, somebody did grab it. I thought it got pried off by a Blackhawk. It was.
And that's going to finish it. The Chicago Blackhawks, in back-to-back wins over the Jets, have outscored them 9-2.